that girl from Sector Zero, Troy?
Yeah, she called to thank me after I got the antenna towers working.
You should contact her when you get there.
Good idea. Thanks, Brecken.
Right. You take care.
Thank you. You got them? You got them? Let me see. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. This is awesome. Zaid gets to live. Hoo-hoo. This looks like the beginning of a beautiful...
We're not friends.
No, of course. My mistake. Associates.
Not even that. Just tell me how you make them and I'll be on my way.
Right. Okie dokie. Got it. Say no more. We have an understanding. This deal is done.
Shut up, Zaid.
Yes, sir?
Jafar, Rice's man really found something.
Something valuable?
Yeah, is dynamite worth a lot?
Dynamite is gold. We could cook you up something special with that. Kurt's a natural when it comes to this stuff.
All right, one pack for you, the rest for me.
Kurt will figure out how to give it some oomph. We'll be in touch.
Crane? You're Crane, right? Kyle Crane?
Yeah.
Erwin Snowberg, movie director. I make the Zombie Annihilation movie series. Yeah, you've probably seen them.
No.
Yeah, they're thought-provoking meditations about people very much like yourself who have to kill buttloads of zombies for various reasons. The details really aren't important. What is important is production cost. Makeup is a major factor. I'm talking head rot, arms falling off, guts hanging out. And when you blow them apart with guns, those squibs cost like crazy.
So you've come to Haran?
It's a tragedy, of course, but there's a fortune in special effects shambling through the streets, just waiting to have their heads blown off for my next movie, Zombie Annihilation 4, Dying Lunch. All I need is a gun nut who can drop in spectacular numbers, and I am told you are just such a man.
So, at last you are here. I sent for you days ago. Are you always so slow? Perhaps you are resistant to my summons. Good. The strong ones are more difficult, but always so much more worthwhile.
You must be the witch.
Such prideful contempt. But of course you do not believe in such things.
Look, I'm here because I've been told that you have an ability.
You want to know how I walk among the Immortui without drawing their attack. Is that not so?
Huh? Is it possible?
For you? No. You are far too crude and ignorant to obtain such deep knowledge. But there is another way. Something I could make for you.
It's fine, I'd be willing to trade.
You are only here because I wish it. And it is my wish that you have this ability. You will need it to be of service to me. Tonight, you will go to the caves while the volatiles are out hunting. Collect as many black mushrooms as you can carry, and I will use them to prepare a tincture for you. That is all I require from you. For now.
Still among the living, Crane? So pull your socks up and try to beat my record this time.
Shops in Harran, mine is by far the least shitty.
Hey, have you seen that house with the red smoke pouring out of it? If Ryze's people spot it,
they're gonna come knocking on his door. Someone ought to warn him.
I've got enough trouble right now, but I'll think about it.
Stay silent. They hear everything.
You are a lifesaver. Those coffee nuts are dangerous. They're basically volatiles that can talk. And they only talk about one thing. Bandages! Awesome! People love bandages. At least the ones who need them do. Other people don't really care so much. But the guy who lives across the hall from me just shut off his thumb. So he's really gonna appreciate this stuff. Say, you didn't see any loose thumbs out there, did you? When he shut it off, it kind of flew out the window. It would look like a chicken nugget with a bullet hole. No? Well, keep your eyes open.
There he is, the best runner in the zone.
Come here. I've got a special deal for you. You won't find better deals in all of Harran.
Thank you. Nice.
You kidding me?
What was that?
I got a deal for you, friend. I saw the whole building going down.
Thank you.
About the dynamite you brought. We've got an idea how to improve it. Drop by as soon as you can.
Okay. Hey, open up in there.
Who are you?
Crane, from the tower. I heard a woman screaming.
Yeah, it's my wife. She's giving birth.
Oh, shit. Is there anything I can do?
We need alcohol to disinfect. Please, help us.
Alcohol? I've got some alcohol.
Thank you. Oh, this is gonna be a big help. But, is that all you could find? It's not really enough. I'd go out myself, but I can't leave my wife now.
Let me see if I can find some more. Hey, it's Crane. I found some more.
Yeah! Great, because we're going through it like water. But, is that it? It's almost enough, but not quite.
You must have a lot of germs in there.
Well, with this terrible plague, everything has to be clean. Spotless! I can't risk my newborn getting infected. We must have more alcohol.
The disease is actually transferred from a bite that causes... Hey, I've got the alcohol. Everything okay in there?
Oh, you got some more?
Yeah. Here.
Oh, cheers! Bye!
I could let it go, but I don't think I'm going to.
We're gonna drink our granny smells down to the ground, down to the ground.
Of course. Great. Assholes. It's me. I'm near the cafe. Anything I should know?
Stay clear of the latte. They tend to burn the milk.
Thank you. Right, I've got your satchel. Now, where's the camera?
My God, you're incredible. It's in the trunk of a black car on the infamy bridge.
Oh, that's not what I was hoping you'd say.
You did it! I can't even begin to thank you enough. What's your name? People are going to know about you.
Look, my name doesn't matter, because you're still not getting out of here. No one's getting out of here.
But then why'd you do it? Why risk your life like that?
I thought you deserved a chance to prove me wrong. Good luck, Fallon.
Yeah. Thanks. You too.
Thank you. to survive.
You won't find better deals in all of Harran.
You need something? Get in line. We're already swamped.
I brought you something to brighten your mood.
My lights! You got the bridge lights? How? No, never mind how. None of my business.
And none of Brecken's either. You just tell him you found him in a shoebox.
You're my ace new partner, Crane. I'm gonna take care of you. Tomorrow night, we're gonna be a lot more secure.
Find better stuff anywhere else. You won't find better deals in all of Harran.
Glad you made it. Go see Kurt. He'll explain everything.
Crane, that dynamite of yours, I'm making it into an anti-personnel bomb. It'll mow down the infected like a harvester. I'm going to combine it with firecrackers and a load of shrapnel, but I'm missing a few things. Starting with a suitable casing. A battery from a truck would be perfect. There's this big truck on the overpass. Well, it's hanging over the edge of the overpass. But you're an athletic type, huh? You'll be fine.
Thank you.
Got your battery, Kurt.
Okay, so we've got the casing. Next, I'll need some metal scrap from the junkyard to use for shrapnel. After that, I need sugar and some cables. Try the shops or warehouses. Bring them back, and you'll get a bomb that'll blast 100 infected at once.
Sold. What have you got?
Someone must have turned the antenna on. We're picking up signals from all over town. One of them is from Hansen's group. Hansen used to run security at the tower, but he thought the building was too vulnerable. He wanted to move everyone to a new location. Of course, Brecken wouldn't have it. So him and some others up and left. We never heard from them after that, until today. You can hear for yourself.
This is Seref. I'm with Hansen's group. There's been an accident, and we need help. I'm concerned who might be listening, so I can't be specific. Please, come quickly.
It just repeats.
Brecken know about this?
He said until we actually talk to someone, he doesn't want to risk sending a runner out there.
All right, maybe I'll go out and have a look.
I'd appreciate it. Hansen ran a tight ship. I can't understand how things could have gone wrong with him in charge.